In this video, I'll show you how to schedule and send automated birthday wishes to your employees using Google Sheet and App Script. First of all, open a browser and log into your Google account. After you successfully log into your Google account, click on the link in the description below or copy and paste the link to the browser. I am just pasting the same link here. Once the page opens, click on Make a Copy. A copy of the sheet is added to your Google Drive and will be automatically opened. Here we need to add the employees list whom we need to send the wishes. Now fill in your employees data. First of all, you should not change any column structure. It should be in the same way how it is now. Columns which are in white are mandatory fields. Rest of the columns in light yellow are not mandatory. If you want to fill those, you can. Else, you can leave those blank. Name, date, month, email are the fields required to identify the date of birth and send email. So, those are mandatory. So, first to test, we will fill the details of one employee. Employee ID, name, any designation or leave it unfilled, date, month. Here you need to fill the number, not the name of the month, and email. I'm just filling the basic details which are required. If you want to test the CC, BCC and custom message, you can fill those two. Now we will move on to the images sheet. For adding images here, we need to open Google Drive. We can see the copy we made earlier here. Click on the plus symbol and select folder to make a new folder. I am naming it as images. You can keep any name of your wish. Created a new folder. Open it. Now open the folder where you have your greetings images on your hard drive. Just drag and drop the files in Google Drive. Once it is uploaded, we need to share the file for public view. Select the file and click on share button. Now change the permission to allow anyone with the link can access the file. Once done, from here we will copy the ID of the file. It is a long string of characters which will represent the address of the file. We will copy the code which is in between these two slashes. Copy the code, click on done. Now we will go back to our spreadsheet and paste the code in images sheet. For your future reference and to easily identify the file which we uploaded, you can add a name here. And again, these columns in yellow are not mandatory and not required to fill for the code to run. But we will discuss about these columns later. The only field which is mandatory is the image address. Now we will move on to message sheet. I am going to search for birthday quotes online. We have something here. Copy and add it to our message sheet. Now we have successfully added all the required fields. Added an employee, an image, and a message. Now we will test the code once to make sure that it is working. So for this, click on Tools menu, select Script Editor, click on this icon to run the code. When you are doing it for first time, it will ask you for permission to run the app. Click on Review Permission. Select your account. check access permissions and allow. Click on run icon one more time to execute the code. Code successfully executed now without any errors. So open the ML which you added earlier for that employee. Here is the email. We got name, message, and the image below that. This email was sent only when we executed it manually, but we need it to be executed automatically in the midnight every day. For that, we need to add a trigger which will periodically execute the code. So for this, go back to your code page. This is the trigger icon. Click on that. There are no triggers listed here. It is empty now. Click on add a trigger. Here we will see all the functions available. As we have only one function, that will be shown here. Select event source as time driven instead of spreadsheet. We need this to run once in a day. So change the trigger interval to day timer. And we can leave the last option to midnight to 1. Leave this notification to daily to know any execution failures on the day. Click on save. Technically, we finished the setup. So now you can go back to your sheet and add more employee details here. In the images sheet also, you can add more images. You can add those in the folder and copy those codes here. But if you have any image with different color, you can add relevant colors here for that image. You can add different text color, different background color, and border color. For example, if you want to add light blue color for that for the text and border, not this color, for any color, first of all we need to know the hex codes of that color. We can search the same in web if you have any doubt about color codes. Copy those colors. Remember to include hash symbol before color code. We'll add same color for border and light yellow for background. A little lighter. Okay. Now we will execute and test whether we got the same colors or not. Refreshing my email. Yeah, here the latest one. It got blue border and blue text and a yellow background. This is how you add colors relevant to the image you use. Let's go back to our sheet again. If you want to send a special message to some employee instead of picking random messages from this list, add that here. So now go ahead and add your data and good luck.